Hello students, myself Krishna, assistant professor of physics. In this video we are going to learn about the Newton's rings experiment. So the aim of the Newton's rings experiment is to determine the radius of curvature of a plano convex lens by forming the Newton's rings. And the apparatus required for this experiment are a sodium vapor lamp, a traveling microscope. Here you can see the experimental arrangement in which we have a traveling microscope, sodium lamp, a plain glass plate which is inclined at 45 degrees, plano convex lens placed on plain glass plate P. Okay, and before going to the demonstration of this Newton's rings experiment, let us have a brief theory. How the rings can be formed, let us see here. The light can be come from the sodium lamp, which can be incident on the a plain glass plate which is inclined at 45 degrees, and that incident light reflected and incident on the plain glass plano convex lens. Some part is reflected back and some part is transmitted. The transmitted light again reflected back from the plain glass plate, and these two reflected rays interfere with each other to form the constant rings called as Newton. Once the two rays, reflected rays interfere with each other, so this you can see the interference pattern. At the center you have the dark ring, and you can see the alternate dark and bright rings on either side of the dark spot. So this formation of the Newton's rings can see in this experimental setup. You can see the visuals of the formation of Newton's rings. At the center you have a dark spot. On either side of the dark spot, there are alternate bright and dark rings. To determine the radius of curvature of plano convex lens, here we have a formula that is given as r equals to dn square minus dm square by 4 lambda into n minus m in angstroms, where r is the radius of curvature of plano convex lens, dn is the diameter of the nth ring, dm is the diameter of the nth ring, and lambda is the wavelength of sodium vapor lamp, and the value is 5893 angstroms, and here n and m are the number of rings, order of the rings. Okay, and in order to find out the r value, here we have a tabulation, so you can note, you can see the tabulation: serial number, order of ring, that is small n, microscope reading, in which you have left side reading, right side reading, in that MSR plus VC into LC, where MSR is main scale reading, VC is vernier constants, LC is least count of the traveling microscope. Same thing can be, you can notice to in the right side also. Then after a diameter capital D, which is equals to R difference of L in centimeters. Then finally, you can square this diameter, you get the D square in terms of centimeter square. After finding the d square, we can substitute over there the d square values as well as the lambda value to find out the radius of curvature of plano convex lens. So let us take the readings using the experimental setup. Okay, so before taking the readings to calculate the r value, let us have the brief explanation of the apparatus. As I said, this is the sodium vapor lamp. And overall setup is traveling microscope, in which we have a glass plate which is inclined at an 45 degrees angle, and here this is a plano convex lens. Below that we have a plain glass plate. Okay, and this is a convex lens from where the light can be focused and incident on the plain glass plate G, right? And in this is a vernier scale, and it is a main scale reading, and you can observe the rings formation using this lens. Okay, so let us take the readings to calculate the diameter square. So already you have seen the center spot is the two cross wires are at the center spot. Now I am moving to the left side direction by moving this screw to coincide with the second order ring. This is the formation of Newton's rings.
The central one is the dark ring, and after that immediate we have a bright ring, then the first dark ring, after that second bright ring, then second dark ring. Like that alternate dark and bright rings can be formed, in which ignore the bright rings, just focus only on the dark rings. In the lens we have the two cross wires, vertical cross wire and horizontal cross wire. This vertical cross wire we are going to coincide with tangentially to the second order ring towards the left side direction. After coinciding the second order dark ring tangentially, the vertical cross wire is coincide with the second order dark ring tangentially. Then we need to take the MSR reading and the vernier coefficients in the traveling microscope. So you know that this is a main scale reading, in which one of the main scale division is coincide with the 0th division. So that is around, it is around 40, in between 40 to 50 and 45, 46, 47, 48. Okay, I'm going to write the MSR reading here. So for the second order dark ring, MSR value is 48 plus the vernier coefficients. Here it is 40 and this is 45, around it is 46. Vernier coefficients is 46 into LC is 0.01 mm, but I am going to calculate in terms of centimeters, so that LC is converted into centimeter as 0.001 centimeter. Here we have taken the LC of the traveling microscope as 0.001 centimeters. So let me explain how we can calculate the least count of the traveling microscope. So that is mentioned here, and the formula for the least count of traveling microscope is LC equals to one main scale division, in short you can say it as MSD, by total number of vernier divisions. So that LC equals to, what is the main scale division, what is the value of the main scale division in the here it is 1 millimeter, and the one division is equal to 1 millimeter, and the number of divisions on this vernier scale is 100. You can see that. Okay, this is 90 and it is 100. Okay, LC equals to 1 millimeter, that means one division on main scale division is 1 millimeter by number of divisions on vernier scale as I shown is 100. After that you can get the LC as 0.01 millimeter. And if you want to convert into centimeters, this can be converted as 0.001 centimeter. So now let us coincide the cross wires with the fourth dark ring tangentially. So you can see that the visuals of the coincidence of fourth dark ring in the experimental setup. And MSR reading is, this is 45, 46, 47, 48. Again it is 48 for the fourth order ring plus, and you can take the vernier coefficients is 75, this is 70 and this is 75, into, we know that the LC is 0.001 centimeter. Similarly, now let us coincide the vertical cross wire with the sixth dark ring. So this is the fourth, fifth and sixth. Okay, we have to rotate this vernier scale in the clockwise direction to coincide with the dot rings towards the left side direction. And you can see the coincidence of the vertical line with the sixth dot ring.
So this is the sixth dark ring.
Yeah. So this is the sixth doctrine, and then we should take the readings of the MSR as well as BC in the traveling microscope. So here it is 49, MSR is the 49. And VC is 7, 5, 6, and this is 7. 49 is MSR plus 7 is the VC into, we know that LC is 0.001 centimeter. Similarly, we should coincide the vertical crest line with the 8th dark ring. So you have to do like this. This vertical end should be coincide tangentially with 8th order dark ring. That you can see the visuals in the traveling microscope. Give me a minute. I'm trying to coincide the vertical crosswise tangentially with the 8th order dark ring towards the left. You can see that now. Yeah, now again we need to note down the MSR value as well as VC. That MSR value is again 49. And the VC is 26. Okay, MSR is 49 for 8th dark ring and VC is 26 into LC is 0.001 centimeter. Similarly, so these are the microscopic reading for the left side of 2, 4, 6, 8 dark rings. The same procedure we have to repeat for the right side direction, and we should consider the second order dark ring, 4th order dark ring, 6th order dark ring and 8th order dark ring towards the right side direction. So here you should notice one thing. This screw we have rotated in the clockwise direction when you are calculating the when you are coinciding the dark rings for the left side direction. But if you want to rotate, if you want to coincide the vertical crosswise with the right side dark rings, we have to rotate this screw in the anti-clockwise direction, so that which can be moved towards the right side direction. Now I'm going to coincide I'm moving this screw, which is now I'm coincide the vertical cross wire tangentially with right side second order dark ring. So that visuals you can see in this setup. Right? Now we should take the MSR reading as well as VC reading in the microscope. And the vertical line is coincided with the second order dark ring towards the right side direction. And we need to note down the MSR reading and VC readings for the second order dark ring for the right side direction. So this is 0 is coincided with the 43rd line of MSR, and the VC is it's 15 and 16. MSR is 43 and VC is 16. I am noting here MSR is 43 plus VC is 16 into LC, we know that 0.001 centimeter. And I'm going to coincide the vertical crosswise with the fourth order dark ring towards the right side direction. So this vertical line cross wire should be coincide with the fourth order doctrine towards the right side direction. So I am moving in the anti-clockwise direction to coincide with the fourth order doctrine towards the right side direction. Now it is coincided the vertical cross wire with the fourth order doctrine towards the right side direction. And again we need to note down the MSR reading, and this is 40, and it is again the 0 is coincide with the 43 division of the MSR, and the VC is the 80 and 84. The fourth ring 43 is the MSR and 84 is the VC into 0.001 centimeter is LC. Now we need to coincide the vertical cross line with the sixth order doctrine tangentially towards the right side direction. Again I'm moving the screw in anti-clockwise direction to coincide with the sixth order doctrine tangential. You can see that now. So the vertical line is coincided with the sixth order doctrine towards the right side direction. Now we need to note down the MSR value, that is around again it is 43. MSR is 43 and VC is 43 plus 64 into LC is 0.001 centimeters. Now I'm going to coincide the vertical cross line or wire with the eighth order doctrine towards the right side direction. Again I'm moving this screw in anti-clockwise direction to coincide with the eighth order doctrine tangentially towards the right side direction. Yeah, that is coincided, the eighth order doctrine is coincided with the vertical line, and MSR reading is again it is 43. And the VC vernier coincide is 44. 43 is MSR plus 44 VC into 0.001 centimeters. So after taking the readings of MSR, VC, LC towards the left and right side direction, so you get the value for the second order as 48.046 centimeters. Similarly for the right side direction, you get 43.016 centimeters. The diameter of the formula is D equals to R difference of L, but here I am taking left side is higher and the right side is lesser, that's what I am considering L difference of R. So after taking 48.046 minus 43.016, you get D as 5.059 centimeters and the D square is 25.59 centimeters. So like that we have to calculate for all the others, like 4th, 6th, 8th diameter squares like this. Here you can see that these are the accurate values that we have already taken, and you can notice the values for the second order, fourth order, sixth order, eighth order, and these are the D square values. Okay, the formula for the radius of curvature is given as R equals to dn square minus dm square by 4 lambda into n minus m. And here R equals to D4 square minus D2 square, where D4 square is the diameter of the fourth order ring, that is 0.065, minus D2 square is the diameter square for the second order, that is 0.0136 by, already we have 4 into lambda is 5893 into 10 power minus 8 centimeters, and n minus m is 4 minus 2. After this, we get the value R as 109 centimeters. So this is all about the Newton-Singh's experiment, calculation of radius of curvature of plane or convex lens, that we got as 109 centimeters. Thank you.